Hello everyone, my name is Taranpreet Kaur and I am from BCom Financial Services Semester 3. Today I am here to give seminar under the guidance of our HOD ma'am, Dr. Mrs. Kanwaldeep Kaur. And my topic for seminar is Corporate Reporting Through Web. First of all, let's talk about what corporate reporting is. Corporate reporting is defined as a communication of published financial statements and related information from a business enterprise to all the users, including shareholders, creditors, customers, government authorities, and public also. So, this is the meaning of corporate reporting, and now the word web is attached with it, that is corporate reporting through web. It means that all the financial and non-financial business information is providing through websites of the company. So, the web-based accounting is known by various names such as voluntary reporting, internet reporting, web reporting, internet disclosure and web disclosure, etc. What is the objective of corporate reporting? To provide information which is very useful to investors, creditors and others in making rational decisions, to assist investors and creditors in assessing future net cash flows to the enterprise in respect of amount, timing and uncertainty, to identify resources, that is asset and owner's equity, to provide information about enterprise performance and potential earning of the business. So now let's talk about the reasons for adoption of digital annual reports. Here the first is, digital is cheaper. Yes, digital does not have to be expensive. One can easily design a website as an interactive PDF using the same designer and programmer as one would use for a printed copy, and it does not include any printing cost. The next is, digital is more easily accessed. Yes, it is one of the main advantage of digital that anyone can access data from any location in the world, while paper copies have no advantage because one can physically do all the work. The third is, digital leads to creative content. Digital system allows a variety of creative ways to make attractive reports. The next is, which format is used in making digital reports on the web? So, the answer to this question is PDF, that is portable document format. Companies normally create PDF files for their annual reports, which is special file format for creating document that are exact representations of the original printed documents. All elements of a printed document are captured as an electronic image. The next is HTML command. It is a programming language of the web. This is a common standard or language to present information on the internet and create web pages. Companies use HTML commands to build web pages that can display text and graphics. The next is, softwares like Flash, RealPlayer, Shockwave are used for delivering high impact web content. These softwares enable streaming of audio and video, multimedia and other rich applications on a computer. So the next is JPEG, that is Joint Photographic Expert Group. It is a graphic format used for reducing the size of photographic images down to reasonable size for the use on the web. Quality is lost up to a certain extent when size is reduced. The next is Microsoft Word. It is most widely used processing application. Companies save their information and documents in Word format. Various articles containing information about the company can be typed, edited, and saved in MS Word. So the next is GIF, that is Graphics Interchange Format. This format is mostly used by nowadays and also used by companies to reduce size of files so as to make communication faster. It works best with images containing solid blocks of colors and animated images. The next is zip files. WinZip is a Windows program that allows user to archive and compress files so that they can be stored or distributed more efficiently. WinZip has a simple drag and drop interface that allows a user to view individual files in a zip file without unzipping it. Difference between print media and digital media. Basis of difference. First is updation. Under print media, information may be historical in nature. On the other hand, information can be supplied on a real-time basis and can be updated regularly. Second is multiple ways. Under print media, there are limited ways of presenting information in hard copy form. On the other hand, presentation flexibility and visibility can provide multiple ways for disseminating information. Third is language variety. Under print media, there is restriction in language. On the other hand, information can be organized through hyperlinks. Increased information can be provided and different file formats can be used for downloadable information. Fourth is concurrency. Under print media, interaction is not possible. On the other hand, the two-way interaction is possible through discussion forums, emails, and bulletin boards. Fifth is personal source. Under print media, information is for a general audience. On the other hand, hyperlinks can provide information for different stakeholders. Information can be pushed to stakeholders through email list, etc. Sixth point is multiple addressability. Under print media, there are some geographical constraints for access information. On the other hand, anyone can easily access information at global level. Seventh point is externally recordable. Under print media, manual ways of tracing the users of the disclosed information. On the other hand, log analysis software and the high counter facility can be utilized to keep a record of users of the website. Reports for multiple years can be achieved on a website. Eighth point is searching of information. Under print media, there is a manual searching. On the other hand, use of navigation tools, hyperlinks, search engines, etc. Benefits of web-based corporate reporting. Low-cost medium to publish corporate data. Time advantage because the user can get required information at any time and from anywhere. Access to historical data. Any investor who wants to analyze statistical trends for specific accounting numbers for several years will have to collect for period of interest. Press release and further information services. Up-to-date information is available, inexpensive to users because digital is very cheaper. Benefits for stakeholder of the company. 24/7 information is available on the internet. Stakeholders can use historical and archived information. Information is reached at global level. Search facility with web tools are available. Downloading and manipulation of data. Information is not overloaded and up-to-date information is provided on timely basis. Benefits for the company. Global access. Hyperlinking facility is available. Continuous updating is possible. Communication is in effective manner, unlimited storage space on computers, access to investors through websites, better interaction with investors, both-way communication is possible, competing at global level generates goodwill for the company. Limitations of web-based corporate reporting. Website maintenance and handling cost, computer may be virus defected, compatible software, requirement of computer and internet connection, may large size of reports, delay in updation, difficulty to locate websites. Hence, it can be concluded that corporate disclosure based on printed annual reports is losing its relevance and use, and it is generally replaced by web-based reporting which has emerged as contemporary medium of disclosure. Further, corporate reporting through web has number of distinct advantages over the traditional manner of reporting. In the nutshell, I want to say that technology is a queer thing. It brings you great gifts with one hand and it stabs you in the back with the other. Thank you for watching my video.